When clearing denominators, you need to remember that if you have several fractions in an equation, you must find the least common denominator before you can go further. Your LCD in this particular problem is 12. Once you've found your LCD, you need to multiply each term in your equation by that number. When you do this, your denominators divide out. 4 goes into 4 one time, and 4 goes into 12 three times. 2 goes into 2 one time, and 2 goes into 12 six times. 6 goes into 6 one time, and 6 goes into 12 two times. These numbers up here are what we multiply to the numerator of our fraction, and notice that the denominators all divide out. From here, we get 9x minus 6 equals 10. Clearing fractions by multiplying each term by the LCD. In example 1, our LCD is 7x. If we multiply all the terms in our equation by 7x, our denominators will divide out. The x's in this case divide out, the 7x divides out completely, and in this one there's no denominator other than 1, and so the 7x stays. We now have 5 times 7, which is 35, equals 3 minus 4 times 7x, which is 28x. From here, we solve for x. Subtracting 3 from both sides, we get 32 is equal to negative 28x. Dividing both sides by negative 28, we get x is equal to 32 over negative 28. This reduces further to 16 over 14, still negative, and notice this continues to reduce. So your final answer for this equation with fractions is a negative 8/7. In example 2, we have a binomial in the denominator. Our LCD is then x plus 5. This is a grouped binomial. Since x has no denominator, we assume it to be 1, and we don't worry about that. We're going to multiply our LCD to each term in the equation with fractions. Once we've distributed that, you'll see before we even distribute that we can divide out common factors. The x plus 5 in the denominator divides with the x plus 5 in the numerator. Since there's no denominator in the x term, we're going to have to distribute that. But the x plus 5 here divides with the x plus 5 there. So our new equation, now that we've cleared our denominators, is 4 plus x times x plus 5 equals negative 2. We're going to now distribute the x through to both terms inside that binomial. And we'll have 4 plus x squared plus 5x is equal to negative 2. I need to rearrange these so they're in descending order of exponents. So I have x squared plus 5x plus 4 is equal to negative 2. Add 2 to both sides, and I get x squared plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. Factoring my quadratic equation gives me x plus 3, x plus 2. Solving for x by setting my factors equal to 0 gives me x equal to negative 3 and x equal to negative 2.